Everyone, this is Kieran from Street Soccer International. Today you join me with a special guest, which is Ash Randall, or Ash Freestyle, he's better known as on social media channels. Just ask Ash a few questions about how he got involved in freestyle football, his background, how he learned some of the tricks, and just so it gives you guys an insight in how long it takes you before you get better, how long it takes you to just get good at the sport, let alone get great at it. So Ash, just give us a brief insight into who you are, where you're from, and how you got involved in freestyle football.
So I'm originally from Cardiff, currently based up in Barnsley, South Yorkshire. And yeah, I've been freestyling now for about 14 or 15 years.
What was the first thing that gripped you, that made you get involved in freestyle football?
I've seen a Nike advert with Edgar Davids. I remember that one all the time. He did it around the world while he was on the phone, and that just straight up inspired me to go out and start practicing that trick, and then finding out about many more tricks and practicing them as well.
Would you say it was very difficult back then to start to learn tricks? Now you've got YouTube and all these things where you can go and learn. What helped you progress? Obviously you said going out and practicing, but was there a community back then that you could get involved with and sort of help you develop a bit?
Yeah, there was one message board in particular. There was no social media, nothing. It was just a message board where a few freestylers would post videos maybe once a month. Like, they'd save up all the best clips, and then people would kind of give you constructive criticism on your tricks, skills, your techniques, and you'd really help each other out rather than just putting, like, you know, a few flame emojis and stuff. Like these days. And yeah, that was a good community where everybody could learn and share their new skills.
So people getting together and just actively giving that constructive criticism, which can often be misconstrued these days as hate, really helped push people's levels. How did you practice? How often did you practice and to get better?
When I did get into it about 15, 16 years old, I'd practice about anywhere from 2, 3, 4, 5 hours a day sometimes. And yeah, it depends what tricks I was learning, but sometimes those 5 hour days, they just flew by. Because I enjoyed it so much, I wanted to learn, I wanted to get better. You barely even see the time go by. A lot of practice went into them.
So would you say to get better, and this is one thing we get asked a lot, everyone wants to get really good quick, but you can't get good quick, you've got to practice consistency. Would you recommend consistently practicing a skill before moving on to the next, or practicing it a lot, moving and then bringing the other skill into it to build them up?
It's hard to say. I think you see so many different styles and techniques in freestyle. I think it's whatever you feel comfortable. I think if you feel like you can move on to the next trick, go for it. Because, you know, especially if you start nice and young as well, you can got no fear. Not much to lose, you can just go for these big tricks. When you get a bit older, a few more worries creeping about getting injured and stuff like that. When you're starting out, just go for it. Any tricks or skills you want at all, go for them.
But to get consistently good, it's like not just do that skill, practice, keep practicing it even when you can land it, would you recommend it?
Yeah, that's right, that's the thing. So yeah, sometimes you'd land the trick once for a video, and I've done it a few times as well. You'd land something once, get it on clip on a video, and move on to the next one.
Yeah.
But obviously, if you want to get that trick consistent, to be able to do it live in competitions, battles, performances,
go back to it.
Yeah, you've got to keep at it until you get it perfect.
So one question I got for you is, what's your favourite trick, or what's a signature trick you like to do? Any trick, you may have done it in the past, or you may want to do it. What is your favorite kind of trick?
My favorite tricks are, I love doing tricks with two footballs, a little bit different. I love doing dabbling in two football tricks. I like doing kind of the magnetic tricks, so you've got like the around the univit or the swirl where you flip it over your head. Like that's a really kind of eye-catching little trick. And I love doing like the skipping rope one as well, like skipping and headering the football. But back in the day I was more about the combos and that kind of stuff. But you kind of move on and find your own style and stuff, and yeah.
You do a lot of shows, don't you, in schools and holiday places, so has your style more moved to the show style now than just the learning tricks for the sake of learning a new trick?
So yeah, definitely. I mean, as soon as I started getting some contracts in for quite a lot of shows, I'd have to tailor my freestyle to suit the shows, to entertain the audience, keep them happy. So a lot of the combos, like some performances I would go without even doing around the world,
yeah.
Like or any lowers, which is crazy really, because lowers are probably the biggest part of freestyle football. But when you're building a show, you kind of build it to entertain the crowd, I suppose. So yeah, I did move towards that.
Who were your inspirations back then? Who were the kind of freestylers that inspired you to push you better as well?
So the first freestylers I met who were
massive inspirations was Dan Magnus, John Farnworth and Abbas, who I all met in Newport
at a Pringles football competition. So
yeah, it was very interesting to meet them. Three guys I looked up to from their videos, and getting to meet them in person was a massive, massive inspiration. And other than that, Mr. Wu, used to watch Mr. Wu, was an absolute legend.
Old school.
Still is. The control that guy had was just phenomenal, like, absolutely unreal.
So a quick final question is, what now being an older freestyler, what do you feel about the sport? How does it inspire you to keep pushing and get better, or are you just blown away with what you see these days?
Yeah,
I am blown away. The youngsters coming through are just doing what we thought back in the day was impossible, and they just make it look easy now.
So yeah, it's absolutely incredible to see. It's amazing to always see the sport keeping growing, keep getting more popular, and I'm really looking forward to seeing where it's going.
Yeah, good. So yeah, I just want to say thank you to Ash for doing this little interview. Hopefully it gives you a better understanding about how to practice, not necessarily how to practice, but just how he practiced, and it inspires you then to go on and try and practice yourself, not just in football, not just in freestyle football, football in general. Consistency is key to everything, to get better. So I hope Ash kind of put that across to you. And yeah, if you want to check Ash's socials out, he's doing some cool, funny things on TikTok right now, then I'll leave them in the description, but I'll also leave them in a comment as well, some links, so you can go and check Ash out. I just want to say thank you to Ash again, and please leave a like, comment, share, subscribe, hit that bell notification button. If you want to see some tutorials with Ash as well, then let us know below, and we'll try and accommodate that in future, get Ash on and do some tutorials with us. So anyway, thanks for now, and I'll see you in the next one.